Today is January 13th, 2023. I am officially 46 years old. I have some errands to run, and I want to buy a record. I make this video to document some of my favorite things. My favorite thing to drink is lemon seltzer water. I also enjoy this white Monster energy drink. I also drink a lot of coffee. Not just coffee, a lot of coffee with a lot of this creamer. I really like this creamer. My favorite food is ice cream. And bananas. I prefer them to be a little bit more yellow. Some incredible things happened when I turned 45. I became a grandfather.
You getting the camera? Here we are!
On the third baseman comes all the way, calls off Realito. It's an easier play for him.
All right.
The Phillies went to the World Series. I performed as a ventriloquist.
Our first performer needs no introduction.
And me and Onslaught won our first match. I was a guest on multiple TV shows.
Yes, we do.
Yes, we deserve it.
We also have the Philly captain here. If you follow him, also on YouTube. So, for you, what does this moment mean?
This is probably the greatest moment of my life. I have children. They were born, but they kind of disappointed me. And I don't think the Phillies are going to disappoint me this year. I think we're going to the World Series.
Let's go!
My grandson's first baseball jersey. Another successful Target run.
This is the way I look at birthdays. When you're a little kid, you want to get older. You're 10 and a half. You're 8 3/4, you know? You want to be older than what you really are. At 35, I was okay with being 35, you know, 30, well, actually, no, I wasn't. I had a really bad midlife crisis at 35, so that's not true whatsoever. The way I deal with death is there's nothing you can do about it, so don't worry about it. It's just live life, because if you live life worrying, you're not really living, you're worrying, and the term is living. Not worry. By the way, I worry all the time. Oh.
Happy birthday to me. I got the Dead Milkmen Metaphysical Graffiti with the coloring book and Lime Cell on CD. Lime Cell is this Philadelphia punk band. My band opened up for them a few times, but they were like... Here's a clip of Lime Cell.
Success isn't really fun.
Rosie Palm, don't need flowers or condoms.
We will be going into the Shrine of St. John Newman in just a second. By the way, it's right there. That's where you enter. It's right across the street. This is probably the most inconvenient handicap space in the history of mankind. Look how far away this is. That's so funny. That is the funniest thing. I don't know why I'm laughing at handicap spots. All right, let's go. I gotta go to the bathroom. This is a Catholic church, by the way. And St. John Newman was a priest. He was actually one of the bishops or cardinals in Philadelphia. He passed away over a century ago. And when he passed away, his body didn't deteriorate. It was uncorruptible. So they have his body on display here. At the altar of the church. That's the man himself. Very tiny. Alright. These are confessionals. So you go in here. Well, you go in here. And you would tell the priest everything that you did that was a sin. And then in here, he would say, all right, say 5 Hail Marys. And then you're sin free. Isn't that great? Let's do a here we are on the scooter, going for a scoot, and today I'm going to scoot you around the most gentrified area in all of Philadelphia. Oh no, my battery's dead. Oh no. If you're going to go for scoots, you need the battery thing to be full. That's empty battery. God's paying me back for doing a Casey Neistat type video with St. John Newman. When I'm riding the scooter, the most embarrassing thing is when my scooter runs out of battery power. You have two choices. You can walk with a scooter, which is kind of stupid, you know? Kind of like not hopping on a pogo stick. It doesn't make any sense. Or you could ride the scooter like this. This is 5th Street, and it's very important to know, back in 1897, nothing happened here. I want to be a pirate! Arr! Look at this brand new thrift store on Cedar Street. This is the Thrift Zone 2. Don't get it confused with the first one. This is the sequel right here. Let's see what kind of magical things you can find inside Thrift Zone 2. The Ladies' Home Journal is a magazine that started in Philadelphia, the Curtis Publishing Company. So cool thing about this magazine, the Ladies' Home Journal, the word living room came from this magazine. Before I take another bite, I just want to share with you my thoughts. How Philadelphian am I? I, yo, it's my birthday. I go around
without even planning on it, everything I buy, Philadelphia Phillies jersey, for my grandson, Philadelphia albums, the Dead Milkmen and Lime Cell. I bought a bushel of pretzels for $10. I even bought a trash can just because it was an old Philadelphia publication, and I don't know if I'll ever see anything like that again. By the way, don't do that. Don't ride scooters with two people. It's there's no way. Also, don't ever vlog with salt pretzels in your car. You'll never get anything done. Hey, listen, if you want to give me a birthday gift, do me a favor, hit the like button. Even better, a better birthday gift is if you hit subscribe. I really appreciate that.
There you go. Look at that. Your first Phillies jersey. You want to say hi? Say, here we are.